Long Run Average Cost Curve Part 7. Each point on the long run average cost curve shows the output and its corresponding average cost. For example, the firm can produce 6 units with an average cost of 8 rupees, 16 units at an average cost of 4 rupees, and 18 units at 6 rupees. At times, the firm can produce all these outputs at less cost, say 6, 2 and 4 rupees respectively. Then the long run average cost curve will be bodily shifted down. The new long run average cost curve is LAC1. This shift is caused by external economies of scale. The benefits in the form of fall in cost available to a firm when the industry grows in size are called external economies of scale. Unlike internal economies, external economies are available to all the firms in the industry. For example, when the industry grows, a number of ancillary firms will come up and start supplying intermediate products at a competitive rate. Another group of units will be started to buy the byproducts of the firm. Thus, the firms can convert the byproducts into a source of fresh revenue. Moreover, new business units will turn up to buy the industrial waste for recycling. The industrial waste also fetch some additional revenue to the firms. All these new activities enable the firms to produce the output at less cost. There is a possibility for the long run average cost curve to be shifted up. Now see, the firm produces the same output, 6, 16 and 18 units at 10, 6 and 8 rupees respectively. Then the LAC2 will get shifted up to LAC3. This happens when the external diseconomies of scale dominate the scene. Negative benefits in the form of rise in cost of which the firms suffer when the industry expands its scale of operation beyond a certain limit is called external diseconomies of scale. As the number of firms in the industry increases, the existing firms will expand their plant size. There will be heavy competition among firms in buying inputs. In order to ensure regular supply of raw materials, they start offering higher prices. This, in turn, will increase the cost enormously. Similarly, some strong firms will try to attract specialists and experts from rival firms by offering higher salaries. The affected firms, in order to prevent this tendency, hiked their salaries exorbitantly. Again, the same thing will happen in case of skilled workers also. All these things will push up the cost. These are all negative benefits, otherwise known as external diseconomies. Prevalence of such condition will make the long run average cost curve to move in the upward direction. At last, a word about economies of scale. Internal economies of scale are exclusively available to a particular firm, whereas external economies are common to all the firms in the industry. Internal economies of scale are responsible for the U-shape of the long-run average cost curve. External economies cause shift in the long-run average cost curve. Finally, we can sum up like this. The external economies of scale shift the long-run average cost curve downward, and the external diseconomies of scale shift the long-run average cost curve upward.